It's me, Mikey Pipes. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today we're at a funeral home in Inwood, New York, and we're replacing some wet return on a crown boiler that's only about a year old. We have a bunch of inch and a half black piping that's used as the condensate return off the steam boiler. Daniel was here last week. There was water all over the floor and multiple sections of the inch and a half black piping that's used as a wet return was leaking, corroded. I guess the installing contractor who put the new boiler in here, who actually left the old boiler there, didn't really care to actually do the full job, and that's what we're going to do today. We're not using the Viega MegaPress, unfortunately, because FWWeb didn't have any in stock, but we're using the Apollo.
Apollo?
Yep, Apollo MegaPress. We'll see how it compares up to the Viega MegaPress. Again, I am loyal to Viega, but it is what it is. Let's get the show on the road, and let me show you how we get it done with MegaPress. Getting a job done, saving time, saving money, and delivering a professional job.
You see? I'm not messing around. A real funeral home. That's where we're at, in the basement.
All right, so as you can see here, we cut back a section of that inch and a half right there. We cleaned the end of the pipe with some steel brush and some scratchy paper, you know, getting all the corrosion off there. And then we're gonna press that in with the inch and a half jaw. We have our drop here, one of three. One, two, three, and actually four there. I'm sorry, Peter. We're gonna use a T here with a slip coupling to connect that joint. Then we're gonna come across, pick up this, come around here to our new Hartford loop connection. There was a bunch of piping here. It was just all done nasty and wrong. But we're adding our steam heel T there. This is for the water feed, which conveniently is going to line up right there. Perfect. Perfect, right? Don't even ask what they were doing here. But as you can see, Hack City, they even bothered cutting down the pipe. See? Look at that. Come on. They didn't even cut down the pipe because it's going to be not within code. But I do like this little connection. I could change the, I could take out the relief valve by taking this out. If this was, you know, an elbow or other fittings there, it may be hard to do, but I kind of like that. But overall, I am not happy with this install. And they think they're gonna move that? You think you're moving that? It's like 600, 700 pounds. You're not moving that. You need a crowbar in there to get that in. Use that piece of one inch pipe. They'll probably bend the pipe, by the way. What do you gotta move? You gotta move the boiler, really? There you go. Frankie Guns, look at that. Wow, wildebeest. I would have used some of the pipe right there, but. Okay, move that out of the way a little bit. Get the jaw on there. Yeah, see, be careful with that pipe. There you go. Good? What's the matter?
Tight. To get the jaws
put something behind it.
Yeah, I'm gonna break the wall.
No, why do that? Right, pick the wall. Put something behind it. There you go. Look at that.
Oh,
see, smart.
Getting it off.
See, I need that little chip. Gotta break the wall, bud.
Okay, chip away that little lip right there. Yep, chip that away. Now we'll get the fitting and the jaw on there with no problem.
Okay.
Press it in. You're in. Okay, one of the things that's interesting about no battery. Frankie. One of the things that's interesting with this Apollo MegaPress is they have this plastic insert which breaks off. Once you press it in, so I guess it tells you that the job has been done. Alright, so there's that piece. I'm gonna pull that jaw out. Perfect, bring it out to the next connection, which is right there. You may have to do a little more chipping. Yep, let's get the little chipping gun. The Milwaukee M18 rotary hammer, minus the battery. Minus the battery, minus the battery. Why are we switching out batteries between tools? There's a one right there. Go. Perfect. Daniel. You could do it.
This right here. A hammer.
Oh, hammer.
Okay. Yeah, hammer.
Oh, hammer,
hammer drill?
Drill,
yes.
Oh, there you go.
You did ask for the hammer.
Yeah.
Now you have the cocky in there you have to take out.
Oh, no.
Yep, see? A good technician is observant of his surroundings. Good.
Go ahead.
You all right over there, Daniel?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's
good.
Does he have to get out afterwards, though?
Think so?
Yeah.
What makes you think so?
Because we're going to have to...
Just press it on.
Okay.
You'll see. That doesn't feel like you're in.
I'm in.
You're in? All the way? You sure?
Yeah.
Want to mark it?
Yeah.
A little mark there. Let's pull that pipe out.
Mm-hmm. Right there.
Okay. Good.
Okay.
Good. Press. Easy. All right, we're getting there. Any thoughts and feedback?
I was off until 2:30 in the morning thinking about this.
2:30 in the morning, what morning?
Last night morning.
Why?
Because I was worried that I was not going to... I was really freaked out for some reason that I measured the pipe wrong and it was going to be 2 inches. And then...
Well, that would have been effed.
I got worried because the first time I called FW Web, the guy was like, okay, we have this. I'll make this up for you because we don't have that. And he was going to combine things. That guy disappeared. He didn't make the order. I called back on Friday and I spoke to another guy, and the guy on Friday was like confused over the phone, so I just went there and went through all the fittings.
At
so
Web?
It was like destroyed on what I needed.
Oh, like, you know what? You need to get high. How's that tequila I gave you, by the way? You still haven't had it yet? La Neta?
It's gone.
Who drank it?
I drank probably half of the bottle.
Your mother drank the rest of it?
My sister. Oh. Maybe my dad.
And your mother still hates me, though, by the way, right? Am I growing on her? Because I'm trying to make my family.
She likes that. What was it that she liked?
That I'm becoming more family oriented.
That you want Peter.
Oh, I want Peter. Yeah, I want Peter. Yeah, I want to take. He needs to be on my taxes. He can be my dependent. All right, so we're getting things done. There's our return off the Hartford loop over there. We're connecting to over here. We have to lift up the pipe a little bit, but we have plenty of play in it. So we're going to connect from here to there. Boom, boom. We're going to press this in. And then over here, right, we're going to round this corner here. Coming around this corner, around, and then up to right here. Perfect. Excellent. And then maybe just, Daniel, talking about the maintenance agreement for the boiler? Okay, maybe you should. Maybe you should. Just saying, you know. Peter's cleaning the pipe. The black pipe. And it's only 11 a.m. when we started at 9:15. Easy peasy. All right, so here we go with the next set. We're going to press in that right side of the T. Perfect. Now we're going to bring it over to the other side. Right here. Oh, it's tight. She's tight, but we're getting her in. There we go.
Good.
Very nice. Good. That lines up there. Viega, inch and a half, slip, MegaPress coupling.
I kind of like that. That little green top off.
I like it too.
Viega did something like that.
Yeah.
like Viega, not Viega.
Like the fittings that they showed us at the steel fittings, the stainless steel.
Yeah, it was a nice fitting. Nice expensive fittings, by the way, for commercial high pressure. We don't need any of that. Okay, and then we're going to bring up that slip coupling. Okay, spin that around a little bit. Luckily, the piping is a little forgiving. Very nice, good. Press that in.
Might want to straighten it out a little bit.
Yep.
Straighten out the
jaw.
The jaw.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect. And press. Okay, and we'll bring up to the ones on top, and then be done with this side.
Top first? Okay, you're all right.
I was looking for the green plastic piece.
Yeah,
this one's a Viega. Viega doesn't have that. Viega. Sorry. Viega. What? They're going to be joining the Mikey Pipes philanthropy organization to helping make the trades great again. One by one, ladies and gentlemen.
One by one.
Perfect. All right, so to avoid painting ourselves into a corner, we're going to press on that slip reducing fitting onto that 90 in the corner. Nice. We have a lot. We have some play on it, and then we're going to come across here and connect to there. All right, so it is 12:04 p.m. Let me show you what we got done because we're cleaning up. So here's that 1-inch drop of the wet return. There's the coupling, an elbow. We had to extend this because this was more than 10 feet. So we used the regular 1-inch black coupling there, went across. We have a reducing slip fitting there with the 1.5 inch 90, another 1.5 inch 90 to go across behind the boiler. But before we hit that up, we're there with the 1.5 inch coupling. That's without slip, so no with stop. There's the T without stop, T without stop. There's an elbow. There's the T. There's my heel T. If we go on the other side, there is the reducing fitting, the 90, the T, and then over there. So very, very nice. Very, very nice. Started at 9 o'clock. 3 hours later, we're cleaning up. Awesome. And before I conclude this video, I want to give a special shout out to Eric, Adina, Aria, and Jason. That whole family, wife and kids, have been watching me since 2,000 subscribers. Guys, it's been a long road. It's been a rough journey, but we're here. Over 100,000 subscribers over about a month and a half ago. 120,000 subscribers now. Really epic. And Eric, Adina, and their kids, I couldn't have done it without you. So thank you. I really appreciate it. And if you would like me to send you a hat, and if you live within the United States, email me, mike@mikeypipes.com. And Eric, it would be my pleasure to send a couple of hats to you. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Until next time, be well. God bless. Stay safe.
If you're not calling Mikey Pipes, you're getting screwed.
There you go. That's right.